I ran my playbook, nothing changed, and it's still restarting my service every single time. You, my friend, need handlers. By the end of this video, you will understand exactly how they work with real demonstrations and 5 smart ways to use them. But first, what is a handler? A handler is a special task that only runs when it is properly notified. Here's an example of a playbook that installs Apache 2, restarts the service, and then there's a task, debug, that just represents other stuff that's happening in the play. The problem is that that service task is going to restart Apache every single time. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to bump that task down to the end of the play, and we're going to put it under a keyword, handlers. Handlers are just tasks that are inside of a different part of your playbook. They're written like tasks, just as you're used to, so there's nothing new to learn here. Handlers only run after all the preceding tasks have executed. But there are 2 criteria that's needed in order for that handler to execute in the first place. For one thing, that handler task needs to be notified by using the notify keyword. The second criteria, and this is important, the task that is doing the notifying must undergo a change. All right, so let's pull the trigger on this and run this in real time. All right, so what we're seeing here is that notice the handler did not run until after all the other tasks had finished. And it did restart Apache, but notice that the Apache task where it was installed did undergo a change. Now watch this. If we run this playbook one more time, of course, the apt module is idempotent. It's not going to install Apache a second time. But what we're going to see here is the handler, in fact, does not run at all, which is exactly what it's designed to do. So, in general, handlers are great whenever inside of a play you think, if X changes, I want Y to happen. Here's a couple of examples of ways that you could use handlers. Restarting a web service after a config changes. Reloading firewall rules after some configuration changes. Sending a Slack alert when maybe a Jinja 2 template has changed. Or rebuilding a cache. Or rebooting a host. You'll notice a certain theme. A lot of these do have to do with rebooting and restarting things, which only need to be done in certain circumstances. That being said, there are a couple of gotchas that I want you to be aware of. All handlers need to have unique task names because that's how they're notified, by their name. And also, multiple tasks can notify the same handler. But even if they are notified multiple times, a handler will still only run once. So there you have it. Handlers keep your playbooks clean, lean, and efficient. And speaking of efficient, do yourself a favor and click that link down inside of the description, which takes you to Alta3 Academy. It's the best place to learn everything about Ansible fast. Whether you're just starting in Ansible or whether you're planning on taking certification like the RHCE, we've got your back. That's it for this video. We'll see you next time.